Verity, allow me to introduce the new-look Diane.
Sorry, I'm looking at this car accident. It's truly shocking.
Well, what do you think? Oh, no, you hate it, don't you? Oh, I've never done anything like this before. Maybe it was too much.
No. It's... you just look so much like... a natural redhead.
Oh.
Welcome to the club.
Well, I don't think she's ever looked better. And that's saying something.
Oh, well, that's all thanks to you.
How did this happen?
Well, you know I had that problem with me hair. Yeah, well, your dad introduced me to this amazing hairdresser, you know, to try and perk me up a little bit. And I feel like a different person. Oh, you know, the kids are going to freak when they see me. Actually, Oscar's going to freak when he sees me.
Is this your idea?
Well, it was my idea to visit Alessandro, but I can't remember who it was who suggested the colour change. Oh. Are you asking for a reason?
No. Before I had you, and before I really had liberty, my life was essentially a conveyor belt of tragedy and trauma, and Warren was tied to so much of it. The cancer, the twins, losing Nico.
I know.
And I hated him. I hated him so much. I mean, he kidnapped me when I was pregnant. He stole one of our babies, and then he came back and he took the other one from me, and he's just the worst person in the whole world.
But
what you said about the other half of me that might love the drama and the devastation.
That's right.
Maybe. And it's terrible. But I have to be honest with myself. I have to be honest with you, because you... you've shown me what it's like to feel safe and comfortable and loved without constantly having to look over my shoulder, and so clearly I don't deserve it.
It's okay, I understand.
Please don't be nice to me, Brody. There's more I have to tell you.
You've said enough already.
Warren and I...
You and Warren... I've been through a lot, I know. You've got a weird, twisted relationship, I get it, but... I still love you. All I really need to know is... who you want to be with. Who you think you deserve. Is it me?
Be honest. I still think you were wrong earlier.
You still think I want too much?
I don't think you want enough.
Really?
Well, the weddings in those movies were absolutely epic. I mean, that music video type scene in Yijiwani Haidawani. We have to do something like that. Do you think we could force our entire guest list to have dance lessons? And the bride's entrance from Humpty Sharma Ki Dulhania.
The one where she pulls up dancing on the roof of a lorry?
Incredible.
Well, we don't have to go overboard. I just wanted you to see where me and Spo came from.
Well, I haven't even mentioned the colour palette from Sonu Kitituka Sweetie.
What happened to being worried about money?
That would be worth every penny. Right now, enough gas in. We need to squeeze another one in before dinner.
You really honestly think you still love Sienna, even though she tried to run off with your kids? Again?
Pretty much. With her, it's messy, chaotic, unpredictable.
Yeah, and who doesn't want that?
But it's exciting. One minute we're screaming at each other, the next minute we're tearing each other's clothes off.
Locking each other's loved ones up in shipping containers. And don't forget that.
Like I said, it's not perfect. But with her, I just feel...
complete.
Well, I wouldn't have gone that soppy. But yeah. What do I do?
There's only one thing you can do.
You're right. I've got to sneak into the hospital and make sure that Brody doesn't wake up.
I'm joking.
You should have seen your face.
But I mean, no, talk to her. All right, tell her that no matter what happens, we'll still love her.
Yeah. It's her.
I'm going in. I'll answer it.
Yeah, Sienna, look, I need to tell you something. No matter what happens, I still...
I'm going to keep this short. From now on, we only need to speak to each other if it's about Sophie and Sebastian.
Understood?
Yeah. Yeah, loud and clear.
What a lovely photo of your mother.
I dug it out after I saw what you did to Diane. Something's not right, Dad. You've been with her for, what, 5 minutes? And suddenly she's a dead ringer for your late wife.
Because of some perfectly common hair colour. Diane hasn't done anything to her appearance that she didn't want to.
But was it your idea?
So what if it was? Do you have any idea how ridiculous you're sounding?
Don't laugh at me like I'm some sort of idiot, Dad. I mean, you were so desperate to get her that you diagnosed your own son with a non-existent brain tumour. I hope that now you actually had her, that these games might finally stop.
They have.
Really? Because if I'm perfectly honest, I wouldn't be surprised if it was you making her hair fall out.
Now that is enough. My relationship with Diana is our business and our business alone. And if you don't drop this ridiculous behavior, then so help me, you will regret it. Am I clear?
I know I would say this, but I think you made the right choice.
Yeah, of course I did. Brody, I'm so sorry for even putting you in the position where you had to ask.
As soon as I get out of here, we are having a total clean slate. No more plans to skip town. No more running from our problems. No more me getting on the wrong side of dangerous blokes. Just me, you and our little family.
Oh, I can't wait. I'm gonna go pick up Faith from Liberty and collect the twins from Maxine's, and then whenever you're ready to come home, we're gonna be right there, ready for you. I love you, Brody.
I love you too.
And from now on, everything is gonna be perfect.
Look at that little sweetheart. So peaceful with her mummy.
I'm not her mum. Yesterday was a sign from the universe that I should give her to Brody and Sienna and be her auntie. Like I was supposed to all along.
No. You're the one who should raise her.
After what I did? I am the last person who should be looking after a child. I mean, we've pretty tired.
But he didn't. And who do you think was on hand to make sure he pulled through?
Wait, so Brody surviving, that was a sign from the universe?
Yes. It meant that you don't have to worry about him. You should take the opportunity to get away while Sienna's distracted.
She's my sister.
We went through this. She's dangerous. And most importantly, she did not give birth to that child.
Lib.
Go.
Look, we still have so much to discuss about what happened yesterday, like why you were driving the car.
Sienna, but... I swear I will never forgive myself for hurting Brody.
He's gonna pull through. Okay, that's the main thing. And bit by bit, we are gonna get back to normal. We are gonna raise Faith in the village like we always planned, and we're all just gonna be happy. Hey, little one. You ready to come home with Mommy? Yes, you are.
Now she's mine, I'm keeping her.